Hey everybody, welcome back to Watch It Played. My name is Rodney Smith. If you've been watching as we make the episodes, then you'll have noticed there was a week-long gap between this episode and the last one. If you're watching this from the future on your spectro-timey glass, then you noticed no gap at all, and why am I even bringing it up? Well, I was away on vacation with my family. We had a great time. Very invigorating, but I'm glad to be back, because while we were gone, our time was so packed, we had no time for board gaming of any kind, and I miss it. Okay, I did play some Summoner Wars on my iPhone, but I miss gaming on the table, and I'm glad to be back and being able to do that and making some videos about it. As you guys know, we're going to be doing Legendary. That's our next game we're going to do as a playthrough. And if all things go well, sometime around November 17th, 18th, 19th, in that area, we should have our first episode up, which will be the instructional video, the how to play episode, and then we'll follow that up very quickly with the actual gameplay episode. So I'm looking forward to getting into that, giving you guys a sense of this. This game is actually already on the shelves. It should be hitting shelves near you, hopefully, very soon if it isn't already. So if it's something you're interested in picking up, then you can do that. On the other hand, again, if you want to wait, you want to see if this is a game that might be a good fit for you or not, then our series will hopefully help you address that. But in the meantime, I also want to sprinkle in a few episodes. We had a few packages arrive. I want to thank the people who sent them to me. I want to show you guys that I enjoy doing these little filler episodes because, well, first of all, they're very easy to do. There's a lot less prep than the actual playthrough episodes. And so I can sort of, as a little breather, do one of these for fun and still continue to create content for you guys and hopefully show you some of the games that we're excited about and interested in trying out. And maybe that will trigger your interest as well. This is actually an order I placed from Dan Crane at the Discount Game Store, one of our sponsors, a good friend of mine, and I want to show you some of the miniatures he sent me. And he also threw a couple of bonus things in here as well I want to show you as well. I was ordering some Dust Warfare miniatures. It's for the game Dust Warfare or Dust Tactics. They use the same miniatures. And a miniatures game is something I really, really, really want to feature on our series here. I've been getting kind of the miniatures bug lately. I'm not sure why. Don't worry, still love our board games. We'll continue to play them on our series. But I want to try to do a miniatures game because I think miniatures games can be a bit daunting at first. It can seem like there's a lot of extra rules involved, maybe a lot more upfront costs, and just I would like to, if possible, break down some of those barriers to entry that some people might feel around miniatures games who, in fact, might actually enjoy them if they had a chance to try them out or try them out by watching us play them and see if it's something that appeals to you. Now, one of the things I really wanted to have is our bigger sort of shooting space and have some fake walls. And if we reached our fundraiser stretch goal of $10,000, then that was something I was going to try to feed some money into. I'm not sure if we're going to make that goal or not. If you haven't donated to our series and you'd like to, that would be a big help. But if not, then I'll try to make up the difference because I really, really want to have a little bit of extra shooting space when we start that that miniatures playthrough. I think it will be a neat series. And what I'll try to do actually is sort of do it separate from our regular playthroughs. So sort of like my filler episodes that I do in between the heavier filming of a playthrough, I might just sort of do you know, 5-10 minute chunk on Dust Warfare, show you a few elements, then sort of in my spare time, and then continue doing the regular playthroughs on a more regular basis. So it might take a little longer to cover all of Dust Warfare, but I think once it's all done, it'll hopefully be a nice catalog of information on how to play the game and maybe even answer some other questions about maybe not necessarily how to paint them, but how to take care of your miniatures and how to set up some terrain, perhaps cheaply, and maybe even build some of your own terrain. So all those are things that I'd like to try to take a shot at, but we'll have to wait and see. What I'd like to show you now, though, is some of the models that I got for Dust Warfare, as well as the bonus items in here, and tell you a little bit about the deals you can get from Dan. I really appreciate Dan sending these to me, and if I can turn around and point you in his direction and hopefully give him a little business, that's great, too. So let's take a look at the miniatures in this box. Okay, so these are the Dust Tactics, Dust Warfare miniatures that I picked up. He also threw another game in the box, which I'll show you in a moment. But some of you may not have an interest in miniatures games, and I can understand that. You might want to leave. Before you do, though, would you mind letting me give you a quick plug for the Discount Game Store? Because he has some other board gaming things that you might have an interest in. For instance, right now he has the Summoner Wars Master Set on sale for $39.95. And remember, if you live in North America, the shipping is free. So that's $39.95 to either Canada or the U.S. if you're interested in picking up the Summoner Wars Master Set. He also has several of the faction packs for sale as well. He's selling Descent 2. He's selling Super Dungeon Explorer. He has four copies, he said. of each of the Dust Tactics Dust Warfare miniatures. So if you go on the site and you don't see those items there, it's an eBay store. So he has to keep listing and relisting things. Send him an email, let him know what you want, and he can get you the price and ship it to you. Remember, again, free shipping in the U.S. and Canada. I like that because I hate when I go and order something online and realize the cost of shipping alone is almost half or maybe almost equal to the cost of the game that I'm buying. So that's a real treat for me. Also, Legendary, the game that we're going to be covering next, he's got several copies of that coming in. He's selling it for $54.99. And he's supposed to be getting that in this week. So if you pre-order it there, as soon as he gets it in, he can ship it out to you. Anyway, of course, always buy from whoever you want. But he's a friend of our series, and if I can support him, then that's great. If you decide to pick up something from his store, please let him know that you heard about it from Watch It Played. It's nice for him to know that by supporting our series, it also helps him out as well. But let me tell you very quickly about some of these units that I picked up and why they interested me. And then I'll show you that other game that he threw in the box for us. First up for the Axis team, we have the Recon Grenadiers. A pretty basic team, no special abilities, but a decent selection of weapons here for taking out some vehicles, possibly aircraft, and of course infantry units as well. It was my allied team that was really suffering, so I picked up some additional units for them. This is the first of them, the Barbecue Squad. They have the Fast ability, which basically allows them to double their distance when they move. They also have flamethrowers and demolition charges. So not only fast, but kind of dangerous too. For some added devastation, we have the Gunners, another allied squad. What's nice about these is you can modify them. You can upgrade one of the units. It comes with an extra figure in the box that you can replace it with to allow you to have two bazookas on the squad instead of just one. Next up, the Allies have the Red Devils. Now, normally, you deploy all of your troops to the battlefield at the beginning of the game, but some troops, like these ones here, have an ability called Airdrop, which allows them to deploy later on in the game, perhaps do a little surprise attack once you have the lay of the land. Also picked up this Allied Heroes pack. These guys are special because they can either operate on their own or be joined up with another unit, and usually they have several special abilities they can use to give them unique advantages on the battlefield. And lastly, I picked up this Medium Allied Walker. Now the different walkers have different pieces that come in the box, so you can build them differently. So while you'll only have one unit in each box, generally they have about three different configurations that you can build with the pieces in them, depending on how you want to use it on the battlefield. Alright, so thank you for indulging me there while I geeked out over some new additions to my Dust Warfare squad. That game, you know, is more of a alternate history, kind of a hyper-realistic, sometimes downright unrealistic version of history, because you can actually get zombie troops and guerrilla troops, literal guerrilla troops, the banana-eating kind. And if you're looking for something that's a little more realistic, a little more historically accurate, then the miniatures game, Flames of War, might be more of what you're looking for. This is a game I've never played before, but Dan sent it along to me for free, which was really nice. Thank you, Dan. And this is a special box because this game has lots and lots of miniatures you can get for it, but this box is called the Open Fire Box. It's great for the new player, like myself, because it has everything you need to get started. Let me show you the contents of it and talk to you a little bit about what's inside the box. Now, miniatures games often have a lot of rules. This is no different, but one of the nice things in this box is you get a 52-page full-color quick start guide. So you don't have to learn all the rules at once to start playing. However, when you're ready, it also comes with another 296-page full-color complete rulebook for all of the intricate details of how to play the game. There's also more than 118 finely detailed miniatures. That's what's on these sprues here. There's going to be some clipping involved here and some gluing. It has several tokens. It comes with several objective markers, army lists, so you know how your armies work, and of course, dice. There's 20 dice that come with the game. One of the things about miniatures games is you often want to play on a terrain surface, and you may not have that starting out, so I really like that they include, although it's not 3D, these very nicely detailed two-dimensional elements of terrain, walls, buildings, forests, and that sort of thing. So you can start playing and have a visually appealing playing surface, even though you're just starting out. I really enjoy starter boxes because they're usually packed full of stuff, and because it's a new game to me, it's fresh and exciting. I know Dan right now is selling this for $63 on his eBay store. If you're already a fan of Flames of War, though, let me know what you like about the game, and how hard would it be for me to build some kind of Canadian Beaver Squad or Mounted Moose Rangers or something. That's probably not historically accurate, but something historically accurate that has a Canadian bent to it. I'd be interested in trying to do something like that. I'll Google it as well, but if you know already, let me know in the YouTube comments below. Anyway, guys, thanks for following along with us. Hopefully you found this mildly interesting. When we come back, though, real soon, it'll be hopefully with a gameplay episode that you'll be able to join in with us on. Until then, thanks for watching.